Kitty's been talking about strategy, even last night at 11 p.m., saying, yeah, this one guy was trying to trick me, but I tricked him back, and I just had to change the pace on the ball. And he was telling Dion, and he had to go a little more forward with his loop. That's one of our other students, so he's kind of already interested in the technique of the game. So we'll see. Aaron gets a lot of balls back. I watched him warm up this morning. One apiece. Got that backhand serve, the whip across the elbow. Oh, he's not used to an umpire. And he doesn't throw it up as much, so he gotta see, he'll get that ball up now. There you go. No problem. It actually makes the serve better. Get that ball up a little bit, you get a little bit having the ball fall down a little bit. Did he lose a point there somehow? Two all. Marty has a forehand that's definitely repeating, and it repeats very well, very little movement in it, and he's consistent. Still having a little trouble with his pushes, but I think Aaron's going to have a lot of trouble once Marty gets it, that forehand into his backhand. I don't see Aaron really being able to do much. He doesn't have any offense, doesn't seem like. There's that top spin by Marty. That's a big spin there. Just ate Aaron alive on that one. 6-2, 2-6. You have these young kids that get so much better so quickly sometimes, but it's a mark of a champion sometimes, so you can't take that away from them. It's important to win at all levels. That's how you learn to feel like you're special. Okay, 7-4. On table two, we got a nice match. Daniel Tran is over here playing. Not very tall and quickly, a few errors by Marty. It shows a little bit of inexperience. 5-7. Oh, that'll kill you there. 5-8. That's a heavy ball. Long pips. Marty knows to lift that, but that's still, even when you know it, sometimes it's not enough. Oh. Problem with defensive players, they have to somehow make sure that the offensive guy doesn't get such a strong first ball. Because that right away kills you. Oh, that hit the edge. That hit the edge. Floated right in there. 7-9. Big first game. He's going to have to lift that one. Lift that one again. Oh, no problem. 7-10. First game to Marty Stoner. Fairly easy, couple mistakes in the middle of the game. He's not being as aggressive, but I think he's just playing solid. He's going to come over to one of our students, Dion Miller. Dion Payne Miller's playing really well this tournament. South Bend, we brought 7 juniors to the tournament. Like 12 people in all to this tournament here. We've kind of had a resurgence of our junior program in South Bend. As you know, in South Bend, we had Zinski and A.J. Brewer and Jared Lynch and Joey Cochran. And then for a while, we haven't had too much. Our junior program really suffered. We had about 3 generations really good, and then we've had like a 2 or 3 year period where we lost our way. But we're back now, and we've got about 8 or 9 kids that are playing pretty serious. And we've got a couple of them that are playing my style, and they're doing really well. And that's kind of normal. The lower levels, that anti really gives a lot of problems. I see it. Marty gets a little bit more aggressive, but not on that serve. As he didn't even throw that one up. That could have been a fault. There you go. He's not used to throwing it up so high. But a nice, easy forehand topspin. His grip's a little bit too Western for me. We're going to try to keep working on moving it back to as much shake hand as we can. But it gives him a dynamic loop, that's for sure. That what that does is that grip Western gets that wrist, the ability to use the wrist a little bit more. But it certainly hurts him when he switches forehand to backhand. His forehand here, he pretty much never misses that. You can see how he already made an adjustment from the first game as to how to handle these pips and make sure the first bow he doesn't miss. There's a little hop on that one. So 2-4, Aaron so far has shown no offense. That's going to be, you know, kind of hard to win. Got to have some offense, don't you? He's getting the ball back, but Marty's not going to miss that. Marty's a tennis player. He's on the cross country, runs cross country, plays some tennis. And he's got a good overhead. So you put the ball up high, he's going to have a, he doesn't miss those very often. 2-5. 1600 final. I kind of feel sorry for the 1500 guys. Aaron's got to get that ball down a little bit with those long pips. I mean, that ball's getting up way too high. Way too high. Every ball's going up, up. Come on, make an adjustment. Hit it down lower. If you have trouble bringing the ball down, change your where you're aiming. There's an offensive shot. Much better. Go for that, Aaron. Move your feet. Use that forehand a little. 8-2. That's pretty impressive, Marty. Steady. Not doing too much, but every once in a while showing a flash of that nice forehand that's pretty much, I wouldn't say automatic, but it's pretty close to that. Use the anti there, which makes an easy opening. Sometimes when you use the anti, it makes no spin on the ball, and that forehand is very easy. 10-2. 11-2. 2-0 from South Bend's Marty Stona. Aaron Heller's thinking this kid's underrated. He's probably at least 1800. You might say he's almost probably 1900, but it's only his third tournament. His first one, he didn't play many events, got kind of a low rating, and then he jumped up about 700-800 points, and then this is his third one. Or maybe he played one other one, but that only a couple tournaments, so after this tournament, he's going to be pretty sky high, so might get a little humbled at his next tournament, because once you get up to the higher levels, the anti may not work as well. You have to be quicker, but we also have some other juniors that are pretty darn good, too, that push Marty, and that's the best way when they get pushed in their own club. That's how you develop. Nice. Oh, nice try there. Nice little drop shot. He was going to just drop it. Come on, Aaron, let's see some offense, because this doesn't work. Oh, that works, but it doesn't work. His first lead of the match, except for early in game one, I think. He's having trouble with that serve, too. And Marty with a couple errors. Aaron's back into it. Yeah, He gets off the snide there from game two. But can he hold it and win a game? Nice chop serve. Good poke with the long pips. Here comes that high ball. Marty had missed a couple of these. Oh yeah, that's coming back. If Aaron could just bring that down about 6 inches, it would be a lot more questionable to make that shot. It's just up there at eye level for Marty. Those aren't easy to hit, but there, that's that one. Marty's been missing that one. That was good, though. He tried to go forward and put some. You serve that underspin to the long pips, you get that little pop topspin, and you can drive that ball. Net ball, big loop. So far, Aaron's made one attack in three games, but long pips are sort of an attack, but yeah, there's no spin on that. It's coming back. It's coming back. Oh, he switches to that forehand. You got to keep your feet moving. Sometimes you watch the flight of the ball, and then your feet stop. Don't we all know that? 5-4. Aaron's lead has gone away. There's the anti-spin, but didn't work this time. 4-6. Oh, nice. Sort of like an exhibition of height. Oh, there's a good ball. Marty's having a lot of trouble with that. Might have to put down the headphones and go out there and coach him. Oh, that's a nice topspin in the corner. Miss hit. 7-7. And we're coming maybe to the close of the 1600. Yeah, Marty's got that one. When they're a little bit high and not much spin on it, he's going to make that every time. Sometimes that spin will get him. This one here, if we go to the forehand. There's a nice forehand by Aaron. That's nice to use that forehand a little bit, give it a little different ball. 8 each. Big loop. Another good one. Smash, and it's out of the court. Two match points for the 12-year-old from South Bend. And there's that ball. He's missed that four or five times. He knows what he's doing on that one. But the ball just get a little bit of hop, and here we go, second match point. Oh, to the middle. He's got that one, and that should do it, folks. In the under 1600 final, Aaron Heller and Marty Stoner. Marty wins two events.